Now, because one of our esteemed panelists actually is going to have to leave rather soon, we're going to change the speaking order just a bit. It is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Martin Pammer, who is a former Austrian ambassador to Bosnia and Herzegovina, currently involved with the task force of the Dialogues of Cultures of the Austrian Federal Ministry for Europe, Integration and Foreign Affairs. Now, this task force offers expertise on dialogue matters and promotes creation of national and international networks. As a cross-cultural consultant, I can say that I'm extremely interested in hearing more. So the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. Excellencies, professors, ladies and gentlemen, dear President Haider, I've been invited to give you an overview of what the Austrian Foreign Ministry is doing in the area of intercultural and interreligious dialogue, and it's of course a great honor for me to speak to you. You have introduced me briefly. I would like to add something. In my capacity as Austrian ambassador to Bosnia and Herzegovina, I of course witnessed many, many developments, issues, and problematic questions in the area of interreligious cooperation. Actually, my experience was that generally religions compete on the Western Balkans in many ways. Who has which territory, who builds churches, temples, and buildings where, and who can gather more people for themselves for political purposes. So I do have a bit of an experience, and if I had to decide how to call my small expose, I would rather choose a title like Dialogue and Religion and Culture, Misuse or Use in Society and Politics in Global, Regional and National Issues or Areas. I actually don't see dialogue and religion as a standalone issue, but as a topic to be addressed in a broader and holistic approach. If we look at daily news, we see that almost every conflict and every issue seems to have a context with religion, or how to deal with religion as a matter of belonging, of values, so-called values, and of politics, of course. Take, for example, the headscarf debate in Austria now, which is, of course, an issue of internal politics and less of a real problem. 10 years ago, Islam used to be described as a part of Austria, also going back to our tradition with Bosnia and Herzegovina. We have an Islam law since 1912, a new one now. Today, it's something you wouldn't say anymore, you wouldn't hear from any politician that Islam is part of Austrian society. Or let's take the many pictures we see from political leaders liking to show themselves with bishops, muftis, and so on, Putin, the Patriarch of Moscow. Or Mr. Orban claiming that Hungary is a Christian state and has been for 1,000 years defending Christianity, and therefore they are entitled to build a wall to defend themselves against Islamic invasion through migration. Or even the celebrations we have been seeing to honor the 75th year of the liberation of Auschwitz. Term anti-Semitism as well as Islamophobia are equally used for political purposes. Today I've been dealing with something very interesting, the so-called US Initiative on International Freedom of Religion Alliance, which has been redrafted, the declaration has been redrafted by many, but still there's a clear political purpose behind it. So doubtlessly there is a renaissance of religion, but not in terms of values and of common values, but more of using it for certain purposes. Why? And of course, I must emphasize, I'm rather a layman in this business, as I have been bilateral representative of my country in 2-3 countries up to now, and I'm dealing with this issue, with this matter, since February of last year. After 1989, combined with many, many new phenomena, dynamic phenomena, such as modernism, democracy, new means and rapid means of communication and information, globalization, religion has a special role, as it is a substitute for many things which have not been put into reality. There's a very enlightening book of Jan Kasper, whom you should for sure all know, The Light That Has Failed, which clearly demonstrates how the ideal of liberal democracy, of human rights, access to the more for many have all failed, and have given rise to far-right movements in the countries of former Eastern Europe, now Central Europe, and new EU members. So it's a commonplace, but actually I think we're dealing with two contradictory trends. On the one side, there's religion used as a tool in power politics, in the context of identity politics, nationalism, legitimizing thereby interests of individuals and specific communities, which clearly leads to conflict between the we and the they, and denies the us. Ultimately, this is a threat to secularism, to the UN system, to multilateralism, to international law and the understanding of human rights, as it has been the case since 1955, as you have rightly pointed out, Mr. Ambassador, Mr. Director. Sorry. On the other side, there's a more constructive approach, the idea that religions do have a common role to play, and that religious leaders can jointly contribute to peace, prosperity, and progress by finding common grounds. The potential positive role of religions can be used by finding which are these common grounds and using them, and by detaching from politics in the traditional sense, and as we know it, and from internal politics. And there are many nice examples which do indeed work in this direction. Take religions for peace, your movement, your organization, the Interfaith Harmony Week, also the King Abdullah Center for Intercultural Interreligious Dialogue, which has been subject to a very controversial debate in my country, and many other initiatives, NGOs in the field, and so on. Unfortunately, I fear that they are not the most powerful voice, and as you have rightly pointed out, Mr. Ambassador, both of you, far right is on the rise, and it seems that in this global, maybe fight is too much, but global, in this global issue, the voices of enlightenment, of rationality, of those who want to construct a good future have to be much more supported. So what does the Austrian Foreign Ministry do in the area of intercultural and interreligious dialogue? We have established a task force for this topic since 2007, actually following the Swiss example. And after that, many, many other countries have set up similar units, similar institutions in their ministries. The German Foreign Ministry has its own department for religion and diplomacy with 18 collaborators. Unfortunately, in the Austrian Foreign Ministry, I'm the only person dealing with this matter. What do we do? We have bilateral activities. We have embarked on dialogues with certain countries. Bilateral dialogue with Iran, with Indonesia, and China, which are, so to say, hand-tailored. With Iran, we have an exchange on religion and law since 25 years, actually, which has become increasingly difficult. With Indonesia, similar topic, and with China about the views on the world, about values, which, of course, also has become much more difficult to implement. We then have the great field of multilateral institutions and fora, which we are trying to cover and to follow. UNAOC, the European Union has set up an own unit for religion and society. And there are many NGOs and informal fora, like the Transnational Network for Religion and Diplomacy, where the United States, Canada, and some EU members are exchanging views and updating each other what is going on. And then Austria also engages with religious communities in Austria and abroad. We have certain specific lighthouse projects, so we do concrete work on the ground, like the so-called Intercultural Achievement Award, where we award every year six specific projects working on the ground in specific countries. This year, it was Bangladesh, Israel, and Palestina, Cyprus, and Slovenia, where we address certain categories, current issues, media, migration, integration. And by doing this, we support these organizations and projects by a certain amount of money, ensuring that they continue to work. Finally, of course, we cooperate with other state institutions in Austria and abroad. We have an own, as you might know, Office for Religious Affairs in the Federal Chancellery. And last but not least, we try to work in the area of building up religious know-how amongst people and our civil servants. Thank you very much for your attention.